Welcome to EPG Pathshala. Now we are going to discuss on the topic flue gas analyzers and monitoring of the COX, SOX, NOX and hydrocarbon. As we know that atmospheric compositions has been changing day by day with additions of the air pollutant which affect onto the abiotic environment. There are two main sources of these air pollutant are, first one is a natural and second one is the anthropogenic. In the anthropogenic, we include the cement industries, thermal power plants, incinerations, domestic and the vehicular pollutions. The amount of the pollutant which are present in the atmosphere is totally depends upon the types of the or the source of the air pollutions and the ability of that environment to adsorb or to emit or to disperse these pollutant. These pollutants, when present in a very high amount, they adversely affect the health and prosperity of the populations. So, to control these pollutants, new rules and regulations, they being introduced by national as well as at the international level. Monitoring is an important technique which has been used to find out which kinds of pollutants they can be present in the atmosphere. It provides informations of the types of pollutants, for example, COX, NOX and SOX, which are introduced into the atmosphere from the various industries. Monitoring system or the selections of the monitoring system or a good monitoring system, it's depending upon the few parameters like the physicals and chemical properties of the gases, sources, their isolations, their maintenance and the safety issues, etc. So, a good monitoring system require equipment for sample collections, instrument calibrations, data collections and their processing. There are various types of monitors that are being available which provide reliable and reproducible data. What is monitor? Monitor is a device which measures or senses the physical or the chemical properties of a substance. It generates an electric signal and data acquisition system, that is DASH. These signals and make a correlation to the concentration of the pollutant. Monitoring can be performed by the two methods. One method is a stack method and second one is a continuous emission monitoring system, that is CEMS. In case of CEMS, it is applied on any instrument for measuring the constituent of the exhaust gas. CEMS equipments, they are more expensive. Another method of monitoring is parametric monitoring, in which indirect measurement of the emissions. In this method, process or control parameters are correlated to check the level of pollutant emissions. It is commonly used method for small emission sources. It provides more flexible and less expensive means of monitoring. The selection and the type of monitoring is depending upon the various considerations like calibrations or accuracy, maintenance requirements, chemicals and physical property of the gas streams and the pollutant, locations, methods which are used in the collections, processing and disposing of the sample, requirement based upon the quality controls and the quality assurance, safety management, etc. Now comes to the SOX. What is SOX? Sulfur is an abundant element which is present in the earth crust and it is found in the form of gypsum. The fuels like coal, oil, woods also contain small quantity of the sulfur. SO2 gas is produced by burning the material containing the sulfur. First, SO2 is formed, then it slowly oxidizes to SO3. Both SO2 and SO3 can form an acid when hydrolyzed with the water. There are two ways by which the release of SO2 is controlled. First one is by the dry and the second one is by the wet processes. During the operation stage, we can control the production of SO2 by using device such as filter, wet scrubber, condenser and bicyclone separator. Wet scrubber are most commonly used method in controlling the SOX. In this, a pressure drop is measured by manometer which indirectly measures the SO2. It is a less expensive method for monitoring of the SO2. The molecular weight of SO2 is double that of the elemental sulfur. So, by monitoring the rate of the fuel use, the emission of SO2 is calculated by assuming the complete combustion of the fuel containing the sulfur. Totalizers are used to monitor the gaseous and the liquid fuel. Another method of monitoring is by establishing a relationship between the fuel use and the steam production for a fuel. Next comes to the NOX. Oxide of nitrogen is formed by material containing the bound nitrogen or during the processes of combustion when air combined with oxygen at a very high temperature. Oxide of nitrogen are very harmful when they are combining with a hydrocarbon in the presence of sunlight, forming a harmful photochemical compound. Optimization of combustion is one of the control methods. Periodic testing of temperature, excess air and load can be monitored and establish a correlation between these parameters and the NOx emissions rate. A clock rhythm is developed to check the emissions by DASH. Portable combustion analyzer is used to monitor the NOx and excess air flow and the temperature, etc. NOx can be measured by the discrete analyzer. NOx is also measured by dilution extractive, cold dry, direct extractive sampling. It is measured in ambient air monitoring system. Then comes through the how the flue gas analysis can be done. Combustion flue gas analysis has been used by power plant to optimizing the fuel oblique air ratio, the amount of excess oxygen and carbon monoxide in the flue gas and least amount of NOx and other greenhouse gases is measured by the analyzer. The stoichiometric point is where all the fuel is reacted with the available oxygen in the combustion air and no fuel or oxygen is left over. Then comes to what is a fuel. Fuel is those which on burning produced heat and a power. Fuel used in the various industries is available in three different form, that is solid. Solid is coal, wood and straw. Liquid form. Liquid form is that, for example, diesel, crude oil and in the gaseous fuel like carbon monoxide, hydrogen and methane. The composition of the fuel used is playing important role for the optimization of the combustion processes. Next comes through the flue gases. What are the flue gases? It is also known as a stack gas generated through the combustion processes. Composition of the flue gas is depends upon the type of fuel and the condition during the combustion processes. Flue gases are composed of high concentration of water and carbon dioxide, oxide of sulfur, oxide of nitrogen, fine dust, hydrogen halides, trace elements such as mercury, nickels and dioxine. Composition of the flue gas has been given below, that nitrogen 77%, carbon dioxide and carbon monoxide is 13%, oxide of nitrogen H2O, sulfur and other are 5% and oxygen is 5%. All these compound, they are unwanted byproduct which is generated from the various industries. Flue gas analysis indicate the ratio to fuel ratio. Flue gas analysis indicate the air to fuel ratio. These flue gas components are part of the air pollutant. So, these should be minimized or eliminated by cleaning procedure before released out into the atmosphere. These flue gases are vaporized or converted chemically into harmless gases with the help of this cleaning procedure. Then comes to the analyzer. What are analyzer? It is a species specific sensor. The function of analyzer, it is depend upon the various physical and the physico-chemical principle like absorption, ionization, transmissions and adsorptions. Then analyzer, they can be classified into the different categories. First comes to the portable analyzer. It is used to measure different locations in a very short period of time. Then comes to the fixed analyzer. Fixed analyzer, it is used to measure in a fixed permanent location for a long period of time. In situ analyzer, it is installed and work in the process unit. Next one is extractive analyzer. It is installed outside the process unit. Then next one is a flue gas analyzer. It is the instrument which is capable of analyzing the gases and measure the quantity present in the mixture or the sample. There are various type of gas analyzers depending upon the principle used, such as gas chromatography, electrochemical analyzer, photometry, IR visible or it may be the UV, flame photometry, ionization, conductivity, paramagnetic, etc. First, we are going to discuss with the photometry. What is the principle behind the photometry? It uses the absorptions of infrared, which is in the range of 1000 to 10,000 nm. Visible range is from 400 to 800 nm. Ultraviolet is from 200 to 400 nm. Radiations by the gases. Photometry is based upon the principle that Gases absorb energy at a certain wavelength and loss of radiation intensity it is measured. It is based upon the Lambert-Beer law, which state a linear relationship between the absorbance and the concentration of the absorbing species. That has been given in the equations that log of 10 I 0 upon I is equal to epsilon LC. I 0 it is the intensity of the entering radiations. I stand for the intensity of the emitting radiations. Epsilon it is the extinction coefficient. C it is the concentration of the gas, and L it is the optical path length. As shown in the figure, by the basic instrumentation of the spectrophotometer, there is a source of light, monochromator, then adjustable aperture cubits are there, which is amplified, and output that can be on the screen of the spectrophotometer. Next comes to the infrared absorption gas analyzer. Infrared radiations is absorbed by the gases such as carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, sulfur dioxide, or nitrogen oxide at a specific wavelength particular to gas. The IR radiation from the lamp is passed through the measuring cell filled with the sample gas. Different molecules of the gas absorb different frequency of the light. If the concentration of the gas is increased, then IR absorption is increased. There is a decrease in the radiation intensity. A very low concentration of SO2 and NO2 is difficult to analyze because IR area is a cross sensitive to water molecule. It is classified into two categories. First one is dispersive IR and next one is a non-dispersive IR. Dispersive IR, it uses the radiation which is dispersed by the prism. Two wavelengths are used, one is reference, another one is absorbed by the sample gases. Gas concentration, it is measured by calculating the ratio of these two wavelengths. Next, we are going to discuss the non-dispersive IR. It uses a broad band of radiation from the lamp without the dispersion. When component present in the sample gas absorb IR, the intensity of the radiation is used at a specific spectrum when reached through the detector. Two methods are used to detect the level of absorption. One is a gas detector, another one is a solid state IR detector. NDIR instrument is primarily used for the measurement of carbon monoxide, nitrogen oxide, SO2, water, methane, carbon dioxide and many hydrocarbon. Ultraviolet absorption. Gases like nitrogen oxide, sulfur dioxide, they absorb UV radiations. The major limitations in using the UV radiation, that is their high cost. Now we are going to discuss the next technology, that is a Fourier transform IPR spectroscopy, FTRI spectroscopy. It is used to measure infrared active gases like SO2, CO2, CO, NO and HCl. It is based upon the Michelson interferometer, which has a function of monochromator. In this radiation, heat a beam splitter which reflect 50% of the radiation, and 50% radiations are being transmitted as shown in the figure. These two beams hit the two mirror which is perpendicular to one another and reflecting back to the beam splitter. These reflected beams are recombined by a beam splitter. The recombined beams are then passed through the cell full of the product to be measured and focus on the IR detector. Next, is the flame ionization detection method. It is widely used to detect the organic material in the gas chromatography. In FID samples, gas containing hydrocarbon is introduced into the flame, air, or maybe the hydrogen, where hydrocarbon is ionized because organic compounds are being easily ionizable in the hydrogen flame. The ion forms are extracted in an ionization chamber by applying an electric field using electrodes, generating a current which is proportional to the concentration of hydrocarbon. The data evaluation is done by comparing the different sensitivity of different hydrocarbon compounds. In this process, pure hydrogen gas taken from the pressurized gas cylinder or from the electrolytic hydrogen generating unit is flow through the nozzle into the combustion chamber of flame ionization detector. Combustion air from the atmosphere, it is passed through the annular slit around the nozzle. Steady hydrogen flame produced by the ignition, it produced very small intensity in the absence of organic compound. Compared the value with the sample containing the organic compound, it is detected. The temperature and the pressure of the sample gas must be constant. FID provide a non-selective total measurement of organic bound carbon as shown in the figure. The flame ionization detector. Then comes to the next principle, that is a chemiluminescence method. It is used in the determination of low concentration of oxide of the nitrogen. It is based upon the principle that when NO it is react with the ozone, then resulted in the generation of a characteristic light radiation. The analyzer consists of ozone generator, a reaction chamber, an enrichment and photomultiplier detector. The oxygen which is present in the air, it is partially converted into ozone by the UV radiations and electrical discharge. Then a constant flow of sample gas is passed through the reaction chamber by another nozzle and both are mixed in. The chemiluminescence is optically filtered and measured by photomultiplier. The reaction chamber is maintained at a controlled pressure and controlled temperature. To determine the concentration of NO2, the sample gas is first through thermocatalytic converter, which reduced NO2 to NO as shown in the figure. NO plus ozone give rise to NO2 plus O2. This NO2 then give rise to NO2 plus radiations. Next principle is gas chromatography. In gas chromatography, sample is injected into the head of the chromatographic column, contain a liquid stationary phase, adsorb on the surface of inert solid, which is transported by the inert gaseous mobile phase. Most commonly used carrier gases are nitrogen, carbon dioxide, helium and argon. Depending upon the type of detector which are used, the temperature of the column must be controlled and maintained depending upon the boiling point of the sample. There are various type of detectors being used in gas chromatography. For example, ECD. ECD stands for electron capture detector, which is used in the monitoring of halides, nitriles, nitrates, peroxide. And another detector is TCD. Stand for thermal conductivity detector, being used universally for all the gases. Finally, results are recorded and being displayed in the data system, which is attached with the column. Then comes to the thermal conductivity gas analyzer. Thermal conductivity, it is defined as ability to conduct heat at a specific rate. Each gas has a different thermal conductivity. For example, nitrogen have 5.680 and sulfur dioxide has 1.950 thermal conductivity. The zero and the sample gas is passed on to the heating metal filament. The amount of heat carries away by the gases changes the rate of cooling of the filament wire. Change in the temperature resulting in the change in the resistance. This change in the resistance is converted into the electrical signal or current and an output signal. Thermal conductivity analyzer, it help in analyzing mixture of two gases and in the production of high purify gases. Other applications include food packaging mixture, welding shield, leak detections mixture. Then comes to the another method, that is known as a paramagnetic gas analyzer. It is based upon the large magnetic susceptibility of oxygen as compared to the another coexisting gases. The analyzer is best for measuring the oxygen concentration in flammable gases. There is no need of using reference gas, so save the cost. In this instrumentation arrangement, two glass spheres, they are filled with the nitrogen gas, are suspended with a strong metal. These spheres are first kept in the homogeneous magnetic field. Oxygen molecule in sphere have a high or a large magnetic susceptibility. Flow, the molecules are pulled toward the strong magnetic fields and the sphere is moved away. This deviation in the sphere is detected by the light source, reflecting mirror and light receiving element. Current is then flow through the feedback loop to the control and sphere and can return back to the initial balanced state. This current used is proportional to the oxygen concentration as shown in the figure. Then comes to the latest monitoring system, which is known as a remote sensing monitoring system. What is remote sensing device? Is used a detector which measures the optical property of a sample gas simply by reflecting and transmitting the signal received after path length through the air. It found an enormous applications in the chemical processing, air quality monitoring, power generations and in transport by monitoring the gaseous emissions. There are two types of monitoring system. First one is known as LIDAR. LIDAR means light detection and ranging. It is used for online monitoring. It is used to trace the pollutant for a longer period of time. This technique used is long path absorptions in which a beam of laser light is reflected from a distant retro reflector and come back to the detector. Next is the DIAL, that is stand for differential absorption LIDAR. It is the pulses of the two wavelengths are directed into the air by the tunable laser and cooled. Detector measure these back scattered signal form particles, gas molecule and from air molecules. Differences between the two, they can be used to calculate the absorption due to the gases. Then comes to the less common used measurement method for these flue gases are colorimetry method, heat change, conductivity, potentiometry. These methods are used for the continuous emissions monitoring of the gas stream. Colorimetric method, the sample gas is brought in contact with the suitable reagent. Any change in the color is measured by photometric basis. In the conductometric method, the sample gas is introduced into the suitable liquid reagent and change in the conductivity is measured after completion of the reactions. In the case of heat change method, the temperature increases given off during the exothermic catalytic oxidation of the combustible gases component it is being measured. In the potentiometric method, the sample gas is introduced into the buffered electrolyte solutions and change in ionic concentration, it is measured by ionic sensitive electrode change. Then comes through the flue gas analyzer, which are provided by the various companies. There are many companies which are involving in the manufacturing of the flue gas analyzer based upon these all the principle. First one is the zirconium oxide flue cells oxygen analyzer, which has been used for the measuring the combustion flue gases. It is first used in 1970 in the power station industries, but now being used in the many combustion processes. All the automobile are now using this sensor for controlling the fuel air ratio. The main advantage of using this technology is that its operation cost at a hot combustion flue gases, it can easily used because these sensor heated at 700 to 750 degrees Celsius. These sensors are robust and can withstand the sulfur component found in the many fuel. These sensors, they can calibrated in place and as well as in online. Automated calibration is also being available. Next analyzer by the company is Nova Flue Gas Analyzer, Nova 7200 Flue Gas Analyzer System, using various technology for different gases. For example, carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide by the infrared detector and nitrogen dioxide, carbon dioxide, oxygen by the electrochemical sensor. It is accurate and durable method of monitoring these flue gases. Next is Testo 350 flue gas analyzer. It has been used to measure carbon dioxide, nitrogen dioxide and SO2. It is easy to use and pre-calibrated gas sensor for quick and easy sensor change. And the last one analyzer is Wohler A550 industrial flue gas analyzer. It is used to measure SOx and NOx emissions with 0.1 ppm resolutions. It can be used in complete analysis and inspection of the burner as well as the boilers. Now we conclude our chapter. Flue gases, it is end product of the combustions. Flue gas analysis, it is a fuel to air ratio. Various kinds of flue gas analyzers, they are being used in monitoring the waste from the various industries, from the transport and in the environment. Flue gas analyzers and monitoring of these COX, SOX, NOX and hydrocarbon, they are basically depending upon certain principles like photometry. Photometry may be the infrared radiations, may be of visible range, may be of UV radiations. Gas chromatography, conductimetry, colorimetry, thermal ionizations, chemiluminescence, these are the main principles. Nowadays, remote sensing devices like LIDAR, SENDIAL, they are being used by the various industries. So, they can avoid the storage of the samples as well as the availability of the data online. Now, the various industries like the NOVA as well as the TESTRO, they are busy in manufacturing the flue gas analyzers, which are very accurate as well as easy in monitoring these flue gases like COX, SOX, NOX. Thank you.